In this video, I'm going to be reviewing GoHighLevel. GoHighLevel is an all-in-one sales and marketing platform. GoHighLevel is jam-packed with features, with capture features like landing pages, surveys, forms, calendars, inbound phone systems, followed by the entire nurturing process. So you've got the automation, like messaging leads via voicemail, SMS, emails, Facebook Messenger. And then you've got the analytical side of things where you can collect payments, schedule appointments, and track all your analytics. GoHighLevel came to me and asked if I can do a paid review of their software, and I make it very clear to all firms that I am completely transparent when it comes to my reviews. So it's pretty brave and they must be pretty confident with their software. So I'm going to show you everything you need to know about GoHighLevel, and if you have any questions, go ahead and drop them below. I tend to reply within a few minutes to a couple of hours, and I'll also leave a special discounted link below so you always get your money's worth when purchasing GoHighLevel. We are now in the dashboard of GoHighLevel. I'm going to try and cover all the main USPs of here and at the same time give a brief overview of certain features whilst I'll go with more depth in some of the true USPs. We're on the dashboard right now, and what I love about softwares is when it tells you what to do first. So in front of us, you can see you've got let's get you on the path to success, and then step by step, it tells you what to start integrating. But before you do any of that, I would recommend going to the question mark and then clicking on welcome course. This has 15 lessons of quick videos that will just teach you everything you need to know and the best way to get started. They also have onboarding video tutorials, a help center, a Facebook group, and support, just making it really easy to get started with the software. Starting off with the dashboard is a snapshot of what's going on in your CRM. So it displays all the opportunities, all the conversion rates, promotions going on, what sort of manual actions, and you can filter them by campaign and assessment, all the tasks, and your Google My Business statistic. Inside the conversation tab is where all of your conversations are held, from Facebook, SMS, etc. So basically, all the platforms that you've integrated into GoHighLevel, which has a chat feature, is displayed right here. And directly from the conversation, when someone pops up, you can select their name there and then even create a new opportunity and configure it according to the stage, the status, the lead value, etc. So let's say it's £20, and the source, let's just go with Facebook, and then do add. That information's been populated, and you can even book an appointment. You can customize the date, the slot, and the appointment title, so it could be a website demo. You can add preferences and then do book appointment. And now that will be in your calendar. You can also create your own custom conversation template. So under the templates tab, go ahead and click add template and then decide if you want it to be a text message template where you'll title it and then add custom values. It uses dynamic functionality, which means you can cater this template for everyone in a certain criteria. So this is a dynamic field which will automatically populate your contact name here. And then you can also add trigger links. You can send a test to your own mobile to see how it looks, and then moving on to the email template. It's the exact same, just for emails rather than text messages. So we're now in the calendar. If you remember previously, I booked a website demo and added it to the calendar from the conversation tab. Well, here's that booking right here. And you can, of course, book appointments and add new leads and contacts in. And then inside appointments, you'll also have a list of all your appointments. You can create different calendars for different people in your team or different events or anything on those lines. Moving on to the email builder. This is where you can create email templates. So we go ahead and do create email. They have tons of templates for you to use, and they even have an HTML import option. If you know anything about coding, this is where you do it and you'll just import it. I don't want to scare a lot of people, so I'm just going to go back and choose a different one. Let's go ahead and just do simple. And one of the things I really like about this email builder is it's actually very, very smooth to use. You just drag elements in and then you can edit them right here, then do done if you want to add in more images. And again, it just works, and it works really nicely. Just hover over, press delete. A lot of the time with email builders, they can be quite buggy or just they don't work that well, but this really, really does. You can change the layouts like this, add more layouts in, add a shopping cart, which is super useful. Under the appearance tab, this is where you can change the width of the template, change the body color, the background. I mean, I've not done this design justice right now, but you get the gist. Also, if you screw something up, go over to action, show version history. It shows you all the previous versions, every time you save it. So if we click on that, it reverts it back, restore this version, and then there you have it. You've got your template back to normal. Under settings is where you'll put your from name, and you can even do dynamic functionalities. So let's just say user, and then the user is going to be, let's just say first name, and then you can do first name from rent CO. Okay, but it's really useful having dynamic fields, because then you can just streamline and make it really simple. I mean, that's the idea of working smarter, not harder, doing one thing once and letting the system do the rest. And then you just go into search contacts and just do all contact. If you have a smart list, you can send it to them. We'll go into that a little down the line, but we can do schedule for later, send in drip mode where it releases the content, and then you've got RSS email campaign. Under the sites tab is where you would build all of your funnels and websites, your memberships. But let's go ahead and start off with funnels. We click new funnel, and we're going to do go to template library. And these are all the funnels that they've created for us. So we're going to go ahead and do agency, and let's go ahead and do a marketing order. This is what it will look like. And then we can go ahead and do get this template. Now, it would actually be nice if they included a button for this at the top. It's a bit of an effort scrolling all the way down, or make this sticky, just for a sticky button, just for convenience, so we can click it anywhere on the page. So let's go ahead and do get this template. And now you're in the funnel creation process. So on the left, you've got all the funnel steps that are included inside this funnel, and you just switch there, and then you can start editing it. Then you've got the overview tab that shows the funnel, followed by the products. This is where you would add products related to this funnel. Okay, so because we've got no products here, we click here, create new product, and we're going to say website redesign. You can also make this a membership offer, but for now we're just going to do create this product. Okay, and now we have this. Now what's cool is that you can actually import your products directly from Stripe. Go into the funnel, now go to products, click add product, and do website redesign again, and then do save. Okay, so now we can include this product inside our service page. So to edit the funnel or the design pages, etc., go ahead and click edit, and then edit page. Okay, so this is a drag and drop editor. Take a moment to see how all of this works. So everything inside the page is an element or a widget. To edit these, you'll just select on it and then you can start editing. So hello, you know, for example, and each element is a little different. So you've got image elements where you can increase the padding, like the space around it, etc., change the opacity, even change the image if you want to. At the top is where all of the elements are. So each element is inside a section, which is listed here. And as you hover over each section, we'll automatically go to on that page, and then elements as well. Okay, so that is basically how you navigate around it all. And if you want to reposition, just, you know, drag the little arrow like so, and that repositions it. If you want to add pop-ups, go ahead and click the pop-up button, and then this is where you can add element and then add your own forms, etc., or one-step orders. So click on form here, add a form, and there you have it. You've got your form, and then you click on open pop-up settings, go into advanced, and then you can customize it even further. You can also make this mobile responsive by clicking the mobile responsive tab. And if we go into settings, this is where you can put in all of your pixels and tracking information. You can even change the typography across the board. You can also quickly navigate by clicking this square button here, and this will take you from page to page, just like this. Okay, then when we go back to this dashboard here, you can go into stat, and it shows you all the page views, opt-ins, sales, and earnings per page view on each of these steps inside the funnel. It will then list all the sales, and then you can change all these settings like so. The website area is basically identical to the funnels. You'll click on new website, go to template library. They also have a video training for this. Click on one of the template, and then just like the other one, for each page it will show each page just in slightly different format. Go into edit, edit page, and then you've got the exact same builder where you can edit everything as you need. We're now inside the membership area, and this is where we can create membership plans, and it shows you the analytical snapshot of everything that's going on, from opt-ins to check out. By clicking on the products, you can click create product, and then you can decide if you want to create a sprint course, which is a short course, a marathon course, you can build your own, or just a general membership. Let's just go ahead and do general membership, create product, and then it shows you this sort of layout, and you've got the overall sections, and then you've got the individual modules, etc. If you select on one of the sections, you can go ahead and add your own custom descriptions, images, and your videos, and then you can draft it or set it as published, and you can even add custom custom file. You can preview it, and this is what it will look like. Go into the actual membership, this is what it looks like, and start course, and there you go. And inside the analytics area of the memberships, it's got product progress. So if you go into the course, it will start showing you all the progress of all the members of that product. They also have a built-in web chat for your website, and to install it, it's actually really easy. So this is one of my websites, and inside the plugins area, let's say of a WordPress website, you'll type in lead connector, then install this plugin here, which then gives you this API. You then enable it, pull and save, and at the front, you'll get this little icon here. Then when someone fills out the information and press sends, it's then sent into your conversation area. Let's go ahead and test that. So we're just going to do Tom Smith and then hello and 8888 and then do send. Okay, now if we go over to here, you can see we now have a message from this person, and we can just do hello. And now what's going to happen is that's going to be sent to the mobile number of that person. And again, you can create an opportunity and book an appointment, etc. You can customize this by going into the widget window area and just adding in all your personal information. Now, if you head over to this tab here and then switch to agency view, they also have a way you can earn with GoHighLevel. So I'm not going to cover all of this, but what they have is they have a reseller platform where you can actually resell GoHighLevel under your custom brand to your clients or to anyone you deem fit. You can charge however much you want, and then it shows the percentage. So if you charge $49 a month for this platform, GoHighLevel will take $30 and you would earn $19, and it will basically be like your customer having the exact same thing that you've got, just without all the resale features. So the question is, what do I think of GoHighLevel? I think the web builder is a little bit buggy when you're dragging images over to places when building like a website or funnel, but it's not enough to be off-putting. It's just one of those little things that's like, oh, just fix it already sort of thing, but it's not actually stopping me from progressing. There is one big no for me though that GoHighLevel do, and that's the cancelling your account side of thing. I have a strong belief that if they allow you to submit your own card details to do the trial or to purchase the software, then they absolutely should include a cancellation button that's clearly visible in your account section that you can click on and cancel. You shouldn't need to contact their support team to cancel your membership plan. And I'm not saying that you will. You might join it and love it. You might join it and think no. But any firm, any company that allows you to submit your own card details should also allow you not to. I never want to be at the mercy of the support team, and I never want to go to a support team to ask permission or to ask for my account to be cancelled. I think they've really nailed down all the main marketing and automation side of things that a business will want to incorporate and will want to know when running their business in a platform like GoHighLevel. Most of it works really well, and the learning curve towards it really isn't that great. Within a couple of days, you could definitely fully integrated your business over to GoHighLevel and probably be performing a little bit better, especially with all the workflows. I think they've taken a lot of care in creating the training material for people and just creating a platform that works, because GoHighLevel, it does work. But these are just my beliefs, and you might have a completely different opinion. But overall, would I recommend GoHighLevel to a friend or family? Yeah, I think I would. Thank you so much for watching. I do hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you next time.